This is your dose of daily market wisdom with Master Trader Nick Santiago. Starting from humble beginnings, Nick has been beating the markets for over two decades. He shares with you his take on the profitable trades that will have you moving towards financial freedom in no time at all. To see an in-depth review of his track record and much more, go to InTheMoneyStocks.com.
Welcome, and this is your daily dose of daily market wisdom with Master Trader Nick Santiago. Today is June 2nd, 2020, and this is show number 46, and our next president will be POTUS number 46 too, Nick. Everything seems to be going to hell in a handbasket, except maybe it's not.
Well, you know, we're just coming off of this real big coronavirus lockdown. And then it's unfortunate, but we then get these national riots that are happening really all over these major cities around the country. So it really is, you know, kind of sad to see that the country's in this state. But the reality of it is the markets are holding up well. And that's really the hard reality, which I maybe some people care about, maybe others don't. But you know, when you look at yesterday's action, it was pretty good for the markets. They finished positive. It was another Monday where we're up. So you know what that means. We're going to do some backing and filling throughout the rest of the week. And today you have the Dow and the Russell very strong today, or not very strong, but decently strong. And then you have the NASDAQ selling off by 0.5%, and the S&P is slightly in positive territory. So it's a mixed bag here. But a couple of things I want to point out. The financial stocks are very strong today. Energy stocks are very strong today. And, you know, we've been talking about how if oil goes sideways, it could go higher. Today, oil's at $36 a barrel. So it's really made quite a recovery and continues to show very good strength. So there are some positives out here. You got a lot of retail stocks, despite all the rioting that's going on and looting. They're actually holding up well today as well. So, I mean, there's a lot of positives out here.
Yeah, well, I guess the bright side of the retail stocks, they get rid of the merchandise that wasn't selling, and, you know, they get to start over again. I mean, sad, but not really a joking matter, but what are you going to do? But retail, I mean, I was just out, and people are at the stores here in Florida. You see that now, due to the wave of riots, pretty much lockdowns are ending. They're ending in Michigan, which had one of the worst, probably going to be gone in New York shortly, and in Pennsylvania and most other states.
Well, it just goes to show you, you know, after you lock people down for so long, then when they get out, you know, they can go wild. But, you know, it's just a terrible tragedy to see what happened, but it's even a bigger tragedy to see what's going on afterwards. And, you know, that's very, very sad for the nation. But you know, this is a stock market show, and that's what we try to focus on. Yeah. And right now, I have to say, I'm seeing very good action in this market.
Yeah, and it's totally counterintuitive, totally contrarian. And you've said many times, Nick, you got to be a contrarian to be a successful trader. And that's what we're seeing now.
Yeah, and even yesterday, we talked a little bit about that. And, you know, again, today's an even better example, because last night you had a lot of violence out there. You had a lot of disruption going on in multiple cities, whether it was Philadelphia, New York, Washington, D.C., and elsewhere. But today, you know, we see the markets holding up very, very well. And we see areas that were depressed holding up very, very well, particularly energy, particularly financials, particularly retail. And that's what you're looking for. Money coming out of big cap tech. And we've been talking about that for probably, been saying it on this program now for about 3 weeks. We're seeing distribution come out of technology going elsewhere. It's not leaving. It's going elsewhere. And that's the makings of higher price action.
Yeah. Yeah. And my guess is that the riots will end shortly. Now that the president has made the decision to send in the military where necessary. And it's amazing to me, in a place like New York, they're resisting the president's demand that they bring this situation to an end and, you know, restore order. And they're going to sue the president to stop the military from coming into New York. I mean, that is just the definition of madness.
Yeah, well, I mean, the things that we've seen, the division in this country between the blue states and the red states, it's almost something I've never seen before. I don't know if anybody's ever seen it like this. I suppose, you know, history does repeat itself, so it did happen once upon a time, maybe back when Lincoln was president. But honestly, I've never seen anything like this, and it's unfortunate because, you know, when you have division among people, that's really when problems come. But I don't see anything that these that the governor of New York or the mayor, for the most part, is doing to really, you know, stop this violence. It's really just disheartening. But yeah, it's the times we're living in.
Yeah, and the cops have pretty much been on their own, really, with no support, no direction, nothing. But they've held up pretty admirably. They haven't been effective. And look, Buffalo's city hall burned down, all of this. Do you think we're in the midst of a, even though it's not necessarily for the market, are we in the midst of a new civil war?
I don't think just yet. But I will say, though, that things are getting very disruptive. And in the coming years, if this is not put to bed soon, it will just get worse. I mean, honestly, I've never seen the media behave the way they have. I've never seen the bad reporting. I won't even watch the news. I haven't watched the news since 2005, and I won't even watch the news to this very day. So, again, I get my news from the charts. Yeah. So, you know, when I look at some of the things that, you know, even – whether you like the president or you don't like the president, just the way the left media talks to him is disrespectful. They never talk to George Bush like that. And George Bush arguably could go down as the worst president we ever had. So, yeah. I mean, it's really, really shameful to see that, you know, this is what we're looking at. And again, you know, as a trader, I just look at the charts and I just go off of them, because if you went off of the media, you would have lost your shirt already.
Yeah. So we say real news, fake news comes from the media, real news comes from the charts.
That's right. And the charts will always be ahead of the news event. So, you know, if you were to talk to anybody out there and they said, hey, there's going to be riots and protests going on, and the protests are not bad. I mean, America is built on protests, but to see the rioting and the looting, I mean, police officers were shot last night. You know, an eye for an eye. I was just reading Mahatma Gandhi. I read a lot of his work. And, you know, you're just not ever going to get anywhere by doing what's going on. But there's an agenda out there, and everybody knows it. Let's not sugarcoat it. And, you know, this is why we're seeing what we're seeing.
Oh, absolutely. Yep. These were orchestrated, premeditated. They were just looking for the match to light the fuse. It came up. I'm sure that the government was expecting it, but probably not right at this particular moment. And it kind of put the forces of law and order on the defensive, but got to realize this is going to end and end shortly. Just like we said, the pandemic was going to end. You know, everything we talked about with the lockdown and the markets and everything else, Nick, has pretty much come to pass. I'm still reading articles from the pundits out there saying, uh-oh, the second wave, the retest of March's lows, it's coming. There's no valuation argument to be made for the markets at their current levels. And fortunately, when you look at the charts, you don't have to really address those questions, do you?
No, and that's why, you know, I stress it so much. And one thing I want to point out, Kerry, is that, you know, we as people come over to my website, InTheMoneyStocks.com, and they'll come over and check out my program, which is called Bullseye Trading, you know, they'll notice I don't overload myself into a million positions, right? So I have actively right now about 5 swing trade positions and multiple options positions. And again, we navigate the charts, and when we take some profits off the table, then we look to enter into new positions. And it's all based on the charts. I'm not looking at the news at all. I don't even care what these guys say from one day to the next. And we've seen some horrific events go on. And I say, hey, the charts are saying this. And, you know, what do we find out in the next couple of days? That's what happens. So, again, I really stress it to everyone to, you know, stop listening to the news, turn it off. I mean, just take it off. If you have a news app, get rid of it. Yeah. If you have a news channel, just turn it off. I mean, I don't even watch television anymore. I'm at that stage in my life where I no longer find it even entertaining to watch television. And sporting events, I'm beginning to not even miss them. So, mm-hmm. you know, I go outdoors, you do some other stuff, you get some exercise, go bike riding. I mean, you know, here in Florida, we have sunshine yeah. pretty much every day of the week. So there's plenty to do.
Oh, for sure. I couldn't agree with you more. I stopped watching news over 10 years ago. I watch a couple of, you know, news programs, commentators, but purely for entertainment value, not to get informed. But I've shut them off as well, Nick, because they've been just getting really negative and aggravating. I'm just not into it. You know, I'm totally not into it. It's probably sound advice. Find some shows for entertainment. Don't watch your news on TV. Probably shouldn't even listen to it on the radio. If you got to get news, read it, because your emotions won't kick in as much. And you're it's a lot harder to manipulate somebody who is actually reading the news than it is watching the news. I don't know why. It's something to do with the way the brain is done. So sectors, airlines, travel had a hell of a day yesterday. What else are we looking at?
Well, the airlines are having a pretty good day again today. So Southwest up $1.16 as we speak. We'll see where it closes. Again, it's got to break through that 35 resistance level. Then it's a runner. But we're looking at, you know, a lot of retail stocks. Dick's Sporting Goods reported earnings today. They were disastrous and the stock's up. So mm-hmm. when stocks go up despite the bad news, that's a very, very bullish indication and also a sign of strength. So, you know, you just want to take that into account. And then if you look at some of these stocks like Caterpillar, I mean, it's up $3 today. That's a big move. Deere, mm-hmm. John Deere, which makes farm equipment, up $3.61 today. A stock I own is Rio Tinto, up another 1.5% today. And, you know, this is a stock I'm up over 8% now. And, you know, just seeing really, really good action. BHP Billiton, you know, metals and mining stock. Mm-hmm. Now that they're not, you know, mining so much gold and silver, but they're mining copper. They're mining things along those lines. Very strong move. Freeport McMoRan, which is copper and gold, but predominantly copper. Right. That's up 4.3% today. I mean, so this is talking to you. This is the market's way of saying, hey, listen to what I'm telling you. We're going higher. That's what it's telling you.
Yeah, when you start to see the capital goods producers like Cat and John Deere, and then you see the base metals companies moving up, you know, copper, hey, we've got a electric future. Whether you like it or not, it's irrelevant. You're going to be driving an electric car in the future, so you better get used to it, accept it. I don't know, you don't necessarily have to embrace it, but it's going to happen, and certainly copper is going to be a beneficiary of that.
I mean, we're seeing it on the charts. I mean, there's no, you know, this is something that I alerted my members a while ago, and I held a special seminar, and I was telling them, you know, I gave them three sectors I thought were going to be big movers. And that was one of them. And, you know, we've already traded Freeport McMoRan in the options field, and we made big money. We're into this Rio Tinto right now. We're up over 8% on that trade as well. I'm not talking my book or tooting my horn. I'm just trying to tell people, just watch the charts. Mm-hmm. I mean, if you're going to get frozen like a deer in the headlights by this news media that is just constantly pouring negativity down your throat, you know, you better check yourself into a mental asylum real soon because there's really, you know, that's not going to make you money in this environment.
Hey, so going back to one of your favorites, McDonald's, it's trading now in a range right under 190. That's a bullish pattern for you, right?
Yeah, that's right. And, you know, I love that pattern, Kerry. I've talked about that pattern on here numerous times, and you could see exactly what the stock has done. It went right up to its 100-day moving average on the 26th of May. That was also a pivot high on April 29th. Once it crosses that threshold, watch out. That stock's going to be a runner. It's going over $200.
So it pulled back slightly under its 100-day moving average. So that means it's like it's building up, right? It's basing and getting ready to take off.
Yeah, we like to call it coiling and boiling. So it's just spinning around, churning its wheels underneath it, building that base. And when it breaks out of that base, it takes off to the upside. That's the way it works.
So it's still a screaming buy, huh?
I think it's a double screaming buy with a megaphone.
Yeah, especially because it hasn't, it's shown no weakness. It's just has a little pullback with kind of like stagnation, right?
That's Yeah, I mean, the pattern is, I mean, it's just all about the pattern, you know, and that's really all I go off of. I don't even care, you know, if you like McDonald's, you don't like McDonald's. But when you look at this pattern, some of the best patterns ever are stocks that just, and you could look at a similar pattern just with the recent trade that we did in SLV. It was doing the same thing. If you pull up a chart of the SLV back in April, same pattern. So all of a sudden, it went to 1450. Once it broke out of that base and got above on the 14th of May, it broke through its high from the 14th of April, 1 month earlier. Look at what silver did. It went from 14.5 to 17 on the SLV. If you take a look at silver futures, it did the same exact move where you broke from 16 to 19. So it's the same exact pattern. These patterns just repeat themselves.
And the good thing is you've been saying it's time for a pullback in gold and silver, precious metals. And gold's down today, silver's down today.
Yeah, and I'm not looking for them to collapse. I'm just looking for them to reassert themselves into bullish formations for more upside. So I love that they're pulling back today. That's exactly what we're looking for. I mean, I've been in two GDX trades already this year, which is gold miners. I mean, we made tremendous money on them. In fact, we did a two-day trade where we, you know, we knocked the ball off the cover on it because the move was so big. And I was, prior to that, I was on the program giving out the level before I even got into play, you know. So I mean, we made almost over 14% on first and second half. Second half was up over 20%. Then we did another GDX play where we made over 11%. That's first and second half. You know, had I just held second half, we'd probably be up 50%. And then we did it with silver where we made 8.67% on the first and second half. And that was just in a matter of a couple weeks.
Yeah, remarkable. And there's lots more good stuff ahead. So you really want to take a look at inthemoneystocks.com. You know that Nick's trading record is there. A lot of educational material free. And take a look at the Twitter feeds at ITMS, at NickSantiago01, and of course at Kerry Lutz. And Nick, we will resume tomorrow. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
This concludes another episode of Daily Market Wisdom with Master Trader Nick Santiago. For more information, go to inthemoneystocks.com and see Nick's full trading record, or check out the Twitter feeds at ITMS and at NickSantiago01.